Good afternoon, everybody. So this is lesson 25 of unit 5 today in our phonics program. And today is Friday, April 16th. Happy Friday, almost the weekend. All right, so we have a pretty short lesson today because it is spelling test day, but I'm gonna go ahead and get started. I'm gonna share our screen. And like I said, we are on lesson 25 today of unit 5. So our learning targets for today are: I can complete my spelling test, which you are going to do. I can review the tricky spelling OU, and I can ask and answer questions about key details in the story Battle Plans. All right, so today is our spelling test. Let's review our words. We have the schwa plus L sound with L-E in turtle, bundle, pickle, shuffle, and cattle. And then we have the schwa plus L with E-L in label, angel, gravel, and jewel. And then we have the I-O-N that says shun in fiction, education, inspection, motion, and question. And then the tricky word for this week was schwa. All right, so remember, we do not actually do the spelling test the way the kids in person do the spelling tests. So let me show you what your spelling test is going to look like. As soon as I can find it. Here we go. All right, so here is your spelling test for lessons 21 to 25. You have a rectangle with all of words in it. We have turtle, label, education, bundle, angel, inspection, pickle, gravel, motion, shuffle, jewel, question, cattle, fiction, schwa. You're gonna read sentences and choose the word that correctly finishes the sentence. You have 15 questions, 15 spelling words. So that is your spelling test for this week, okay? All right, so what I want you to do, we are going to do ABC order, okay? So get out your phonics journal. We don't use these much anymore. And I want you to turn to page 62. Stop sharing. Turn to page 62. You're going to put today's date on the top, 4-16, and write 1 through 5 because you are going to take 5 words and place them in ABC order. But you need to do this part first. So go ahead and pause the video and then put these on page 62 and then hit play when you are ready. All right, so here are the 5 words, that you are going to put in ABC order. You have the word turtle, question, cattle, gravel, and jewel. And as you see here, you have a 4-minute timer to put those words in order. So you can pause the video if you need to, or just let it keep playing while I have the timer going. Ready, set, go. Okay, that scared my cat. All right, so 4 minutes are up. Let's check your work. So you should have number one was cattle. Number two was gravel. Number three was jewel. Four was question. And number five was turtle. Did you guys get those right? How many did you get right? Good job, guys. All right, so we are going to look at worksheet 25.2. You have completed many sheets similar to this one in the past. Obviously, I'm not going to work with a small group. We're just going to go over it, and you're going to do it independently on your own. It's just like we did one of these yesterday. Let's see. So this is the tricky O spelling. Okay, so this is worksheet 25.2, and it's the tricky OU spelling. You are going to write the words that have the tricky spelling OU that sounds like ow, and under shout. And the words that have the tricky spelling OU that sound like under the word touch. So does it say ow or OU can make those two separate sounds. OU can say ow, like shout, out, and mountain. Or it can say like touch, country, and jealous. All right, so each sentence has a word that is underlined, and that word has the OU spelling in it for today. You have two columns. The first column says ow, as in shout. The second column says as in touch. So the first sentence is he old or young? Young is the underlined word. So is it the OU, does it say ow, young, or does it say young? Yeah, it says as in young, so as in touch. So they put young in the second column. So then look at the second sentence. The sky has lots of clouds. Does it say ow, like shout, or like touch? Is it clouds or cluds? Yeah, it's clouds. So it's going to go in the first column. So you are going to read 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7 and look at those words that are underlined and decide how does the OU sound? Does it sound like ow or does it sound like Okay, so it is time for our new story. And today's story is called Battle Plans. So today we are going to read about King Alfred's knights preparing to do battle against King Henry's knights. But before we start, let's preview some spellings. We have the OL, which is the schwa plus L in little and mumbled. We have the sound with letter A. Excuse me. In the words about, away, and assist. And then we have the GE spelling for the sound J. That doesn't go there at all. That is labeled wrong. It's supposed to be O as the sound in bottom, other, and together. So the label is, the heading is wrong. Let's look at some of our vocabulary. We have the words volunteer, which means to offer to do something. Stunned means you are surprised. The enemy's position is the location of the enemy. A moment of glory is a time when someone receives attention and praise. Delighted means you are pleased. And the phrase are camped means that you are placed in a forest or under some kind of cover for sleeping and resting. So I want you to be thinking while you're listening to the story of a think, pair, what question to ask the class at the end of the story. So remember, a think, pair, what question is you're going to think about it, you're going to tell it to somebody else, and then you're going to tell it to the class. Okay, it's going to be kind of hard since we're not together, but you can at least pretend to tell me about it. All right, so we are in, hold on one second. So we are in our Unit 5 reader, Sir Gus, and today we are on Chapter 16, Battle Plans. It starts on page 126. Battle Plans. Yes, I pick you, Sir Gus. Why, who else would I pick? Said the king. I have lost count of all the times you have saved me. You see, the king believed Sir Gus had fallen off his chair in his eagerness to volunteer to lead the army. You must get started, Sir Gus, the king went on. You must prepare your army. The other good knights will assist you with your battle plans. Good luck. With those words, the king left the room and went off to walk his dog. The other guys look so astonished. Sir Gus was stunned. Me? He mumbled. Yes, you, shouted all 11 knights together. Sir Tom reached for a map of King Henry's kingdom. You will need this, said Sir Tom. He was feeling a little sad that King Alfred had not chosen him, but what could he do? The map shows all of the hills, rivers, and valleys in King Henry's kingdom, Sir Tom explained. Thank you, said Sir Gus. He did not understand why he would need a map that showed hills, rivers, and valleys, unless it was to point out the best places to hide. Still, he took the map and pretended to look at it. Sir Gus, said Sir Tom, you are holding the map upside down. Am I? Said Sir Gus. Then he added, oh, yes, I am. You see, I am trying to get a sense of how things might look from the enemy's position. What is your plan? Asked Sir Ed. Like Sir Tom, he was sad that he was not chosen to lead the attack, but there was not much he could do about it. Do you plan a sudden attack at night with some of the army, or an all-out attack at sunrise? Excuse me. With the entire army. Sunrise, said Sir Gus. That is in the morning. No, I think the attack at night is a much better plan. If you like, Sir Ed, you could lead the sudden attack, and I could stay with the rest of the army and keep them safe. I could not take this moment of glory away from you, said Sir Ed. It would not be fair. Sure you can, replied Sir Gus. I mean, you must not feel bad. I have other plans up my sleeve, plans that will soon be revealed. Well, if you really don't mind, said Sir Ed, I would be delighted. Sir Ed was starting to feel much happier about everything. I have just one request, said Sir Ed. Yes, Sir Gus, what is it? Said Sir Gus, what is it? The Black Knight and his men are camped in the fields of the west, explained Sir Ed. I would like to attack them there, and I would like to take Sir Tom with me. He can lead our knights in battle while I lead our foot troops. I was just about to say the very same thing, announced Sir Gus. Wonderful, said Sir Ed. Excellent. Splendid, said Sir Tom. Fantastic. By this point, Sir Tom and Sir Ed were both feeling a lot happier. It seems we have a good plan, said Sir Tom. We will go and get the horses. Good idea, said Sir Gus. I will stay here and make sure the rest of the army stays safe.
11 of the knights went off to prepare for battle. Sir Gus went off to find someone who could stop the awful pain he was feeling in his bottom. So, what were some things that you were thinking? What questions were you thinking when you were listening to the story? I'm kind of wondering, did the knights do that on purpose? Like, did they pretend to let Sir Gus make the plans because they knew that he really did not have a plan at all? What do you guys think? What were your questions? Okay, so let's summarize the story. In the beginning of the story, the king gives Sir Gus to be in charge of the army. And after that, he goes to make the battle plan. And Sir Tom gives him the map. And then Sir Tom and Sir Ed continue to talk to Sir Gus about his plan. And they come up with a plan that's better suited for them than it is for Sir Gus. And in the end, Sir Tom and Sir Ed go to get the battle horses ready, and Sir Gus goes to find someone to help the bee sting on his tushy. Okay, so the last thing that you have to do for me today is you are going to answer questions about the story battle plans, okay? You're going to use your text box to answer the questions. The king thinks that Sir Gus has volunteered to lead the army. Why does the king think that? What does Sir Tom hand to Sir Gus? What is the real reason that Sir Gus holds the map upside down? Why do you think Sir Gus chooses to attack at night? At the end of the story, why are Sir Ed and Sir Tom happy? And are you like Sir Ed or are you like Sir Gus? Explain your answer. Okay, so your learning targets for today were: I can complete my spelling test, which you're going to do as soon as you're done with today's video. I can review the tricky spelling OU that says ow or and I can ask and answer questions about key details in the story battle plan. So that is actually the end of today's lesson. It's super short. So remember, you have 3 worksheets to work on today. You have the tricky OU spelling worksheet. You have the questions to answer on battle plans. You have one more. Hold on. What was it? Oh, the spelling test. Duh. The spelling test. So those are the 3 that you have to work on today. And then that's it. That's all you've got. There's no spelling work today. You will have grammar work today to work on to continue reviewing verbs. And I will have that up for you at some point this morning. And that is all, guys. I hope you have a great weekend. I'll see you on Monday. Bye. Oh, wait. I do this every time, don't I? I gotta share the word of the day. Ben. Oh, lunch. That's a good word. Lunch is a good word. Lunch is a good word. Okay. So now I'm going to say goodbye. Everyone have a great weekend. I will see you on Monday. Bye, guys.